Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to Friday Knits. Today I'm going to be showing you how to attach a zipper to your knitwear. So if you're here, I assume maybe you're making something with a zipper, or you're making my design for my zipper jacket thing. I don't think I have a name for it yet. So yeah, it's the zipper jacket thing. So today I am going to show you how to put in the zipper. So here you can see my things. I'm still knitting it, but I thought I would put it in just so I could have a look at what it looks like. I like to see what something looks like before I get too much into it. So I'm using a very chunky zipper here that I purchased from Spotlight. And this is also a 35 centimeter zip as well. So that is a little info on that. And now I'm just gonna go into it and show you how to attach it on. So here you can see I've already sort of done this side. I was recording this side, and then I actually messed it up a bit because these stitches up here didn't look that great, and so I was like, oh, I'll just like redo it, so you know the right way to do it. Here I'm going to show you how to do it on this side. So I've already done the pinning down, and that's the first thing you want to do is pin it down. You can see I've just got some regular sewing pins here, and on the back here you've got another knit strip that you use just so you can cover the inside of it, and then that's also going to be seam together with the zip. So I've already popped it in and sort of lined it up, and now I'm going to just start seaming down here like that. So what you want is you want your just a regular sewing thread and a needle, and here I'm using just white thread because I didn't have thread that was in this color, but that's okay because it'll be mostly hidden. Not on this side though, let's not talk about that. But here I'm gonna show you guys how to do it so it doesn't get shown too much. So when you've pinned it down like that, you'll begin at the top here. So this zip had a bit of a top part, I assume all zips do. So I just folded it in sort of at an angle like this, just so that it stays kind of hidden. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna seam that down. And now what I'm doing is I'm actually gonna go between stitches here. So you see this like V, it's like the V stitch of your knit. I'm gonna go and sew between those stitches. So I'm gonna go from the back to the front and pull that through. And I tied a little knot here, but I like to leave a little gap there just so I can secure it down, and just because I'm paranoid. I should also say I'm not a great sewer, so I'm gonna be referring to sewing terms, but I think they're gonna be wrong. Like, I think I'm doing backstitch, but I'm probably not. It's just some sort of stitch to secure it down. And because you won't see it, it's not that big of a deal. So yeah. So what I'm doing now is I'm just going back and forth into the same stitch just to secure it down at the beginning. And I've done that about two or three times now. So now I'm going to continue down, I think, maybe this line here. So I did refer to I think that V line there, but I'm actually going to go down this V line here that you can see because it's sort of right on the edge, and I think that'll be a nice edge along here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through that first stitch like that, and then I'm going to into this like next V, go in like that gap where they sort of join, and just make sure you're catching the yarn at the back as well. So I'm going to just push that through like that. That's not very neat. Again, I'm not a great sewer, so I'm sort of just doing this as best as I can, but I think there's much more talented people out there who can do this. All right. So now I'm going to go back through to the front, and I'm just going like next to it next to the last stitch I did, which you can't see because it's under all the yarn, but you just sort of keep going down the line. At the back here, it doesn't matter too much, I guess, like where you pick up, or I guess it does because you might see it. So you want it to be, I guess, kind of neat. So I will neaten it up there. And back here, I'm going to follow this V line here of stitches. You can see there. And so I'm going to go through that stitch there. And then I'm going to go through the front here and follow, like, yeah, again, that, probably a bit more down that V line there. Yeah, that looks good. And you can see that you can't even see the thread if you just put it sort of between the stitches. So now I'm going to go through the other side and then keep going down. I probably should have said earlier as a tip is that maybe it's best to, when you're pinning it down, really pin it down as neatly as you can first up, so that when you are seaming down, it's just a lot easier. And if you pin down, try not to pin down like on the line that you want to use. So here I have done that. So when I get to there, I'll probably end up moving it over, or I might just go over it. I'll see how it goes. But I think for now, I'm just going to keep going here. Okay, so that is completely knit up now. You can see it's also knit along that edge. I still haven't finished here. I actually need to record that for my Instagram, so I've just left that for now so I can just record it in a bit for my Instagram. But that is done for this side. So my bike isn't that neat. It's really not the best, but I think it's still, it'll do for now. And you can sort of still see the stitches there where I missed a little bit, but that's okay. I'm okay with that. And it's not as neat along the edge, but for me, as long as it doesn't catch on the zip, I'm totally okay with that. And it still zips up totally fine. Bad example. There we go. So here, it's all like nicely along the edge. This is mostly to do with my stitching, so I'm just hoping that when I block it, it'll come out a little nicer. But yeah, it sort of opens and closes as I like, and I'm quite happy with it. So I hope that helped you guys figure out how to sew the zipper in, and yeah, thanks for watching. So I'll see you next time.